Hi everyone, welcome to Excel Clinic, the accountant series. In this episode, we will be building a prepayment or amortization schedule from scratch. Follow me, no OT. Subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification so that you will not miss a single episode. I always emphasize that Excel is your assistant. Before you can train your assistant, you must know how to get things done yourself. So let's revisit the basics. What is prepayment? We pay for something first, and we consume or receive the service later. We debit prepayment a balance sheet account and credit cash or bank when we pay. Then, at a regular interval, usually we do it monthly, we amortize the prepayment as we receive the service or goods. We debit an expense account and credit prepayment. This is a typical scenario. In certain circumstances, we may also debit another asset if it is so required by another accounting standard. Consider this example. We pay $100 on 1st January for 4 months web hosting service. Upon payment, you will pass an entry, debit prepayment $100, credit cash or bank $100. Over the next 4 months, we will amortize $25 each month to P&L, debit web hosting expense $25, and credit prepayment $25. The prepayment balance will be reduced by 25 each month to 75 at 31st January and so on. It will be reduced to zero on 30th April. This is a very simple example of a prepayment scenario and what accountants need to do. Now, let's see what a good prepayment schedule can offer. Why do we need a prepayment schedule? Here are the five reasons. First, it helps you to compute the amount to be amortized automatically every month. Two, it makes sure that you don't miss out any prepayment items accidentally. Imagine that you have a list of 100 prepayment items. How can you be sure that you will not miss a single item out? Use a prepayment schedule. A good prepayment schedule should also provide you with a theoretical balance of your prepayment account. You can then compare this theoretical balance against your GL balance and therefore support the GL balance. Number 4. A good prepayment schedule doesn't just compute the amortization for current month, but also for the subsequent months. This gives you a structured set of data to forecast your accounting expense for the subsequent months. Lastly, a well-designed prepayment schedule can double up as a contract expiry tracker. You know that it is a time to renew a service contract if the amortization is about to end. So let's build the prepayment schedule from scratch. First, let's set up the headers. Item number, description, invoice amount, service start, service end. We will be building the prepayment schedule for the whole year. So it will start with January 2022 and fill it for the next 11 months. I always like to enter a sample record as I build the formulas so that I can get instant feedback if the formulas or functions I write is not working. So let's use the sample example we went through earlier. Item number one, web hosting service, $100. But to better illustrate how to do this template, it shall start from February instead and end by the month of May 2022. How do we compute the amortization amount for February 2022? Equals C2 divided by 4. But we know that this is not the way we build a reusable Excel template. We need to teach Excel to fish to compute the number of months by itself, so that you will not be calculating this manually and changing this variable for each item in the prepayment schedule. We need a helper column. Let's call it length of service. The function we need to compute the number of months is datedif. Equals datedif. The first argument is the start date. The second argument is the end date. And the third argument is text M. It represents the month. followed by plus one, so that it will return the number of months with start and end months inclusive. The dateDiff function returns 4. Replace the 4 in the formula in cell H2 with a reference to F2. Copy the functions to the other columns. Remember to make reference to the columns absolute. Otherwise, as we copy to other columns, the reference cell will move as well. Don't fix the row, otherwise you will not be able to copy to the next rows if you have more than one record. If you sum February to May, you will get $100, the exact amount we are looking for. But Jan, June, and subsequent month should not have any amortization amount. To do this, we need to ask Excel to compute the amortization amount only when the month of the particular column fall within the service period. To better illustrate this, and especially for those who are not familiar with logical functions of Excel, I will do this in two steps. Let's tackle the issues for January first. We need an if function. Excel should only compute the amortizations if Jan is on or after the service start date. Equals if. The first argument is condition. In this case, it is January greater or equals to service start date. G1 greater or equal to D2. And again, remember to make row 1 and column D absolute. The second argument is what we want Excel to do when the condition is filled. So that is our original formula. The third argument is what we want Excel to do when the condition is not fulfilled. We want Excel to return 0. Now, the second step is to fix June and subsequent months. Excel should only compute the amortization if June is on or before the service end date. There is only one argument in if function for condition. To add another condition, and it is an end condition, we need the end function. Nest the first if argument in an end function. The second argument in the end function, June, less than or equal to service end date. Again, make row 1 and column E absolute. So a very simple prepayment schedule is done, but I will give it an upgrade. We computed the monthly amortization amount, but if you want to use this as a balance sheet schedule, then you need a schedule that gives you the end balance for the current month. Let's add a column at the end. Let's call it balance as at February 2022. The formula will be C2, the invoice amount, less the sum of G2 to H2. Well, some people are actually okay with this and update the formula every month. But again, a good spreadsheet designer won't do this. To make this dynamic, you need to ask yourself what tells you that you only need to sum G to H. The month you are preparing the schedule for. So you need to tell Excel the same thing. Add a few rows above and give this table a title. Prepayment schedule as at. Enter the date in the next cell. There are a couple of functions you can use to achieve the same result. Sum ifs, sum plus offset, or sum product. My personal preference is sum ifs. It is the cleanest, most efficient, and easy to understand. We need Excel to sum all amortizations for all the months before and including the current month. Equals sum ifs. The first argument is the sum range, the monthly cell for this record. The second argument is the criteria range, the header. And again, remember to make it absolute because it will not move. The final argument is the criteria itself. You need to wrap the operator less than or equal to in double quotation marks and join with the current month, the month you are preparing the schedule for. How about the column header? I don't want to change this manually when March comes. What you need to do to make it dynamic: wrap the tax constant, balance as at, with double quotation marks. Remove the rest and reference it to the scheduled date. Oops, your readers certainly don't understand 44593. This is how Excel remembers dates, but it is actually not human friendly. Use function text to convert 44593 to MMMYYYY. Do a test. At the end of Feb, this prepayment item should have a balance of 75. Good. Here you go. Now it is time to do some self-formatting and make it look nicer. So far, we are amortizing the prepayment by month. Since we are using computer to do the computations, instead of computing manually or using a calculator, can we compute the amortization amount based on the number of days? The answer is yes. And there are actually a couple of benefits to do so. First, it is more accurate. Second, service periods may not always start on day one of a month and end on the last day of another month. If it starts on the last day of the month, should we record amortization for the entire month? You can do some tweak and upgrade it to days. What you need to do: subscribe to my YouTube channel, drop me an email or PM me on Facebook or LinkedIn. I will share the sample file with you. Let me know what topic you'd like me to cover next by commenting down below. I will be showing you more Excel tips and tricks. So do subscribe and turn on the notification so that you will not miss the next episode. Share this video with your fellow Excel user and say no to OT.